What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to customize Windows 11 start menu layout and then deploy it for deployment. So let's get right into it. All right, so customizing your Windows 11 start menu and deploying it during MDT or SCCM. Now, within this video, I'm going to do MDT, but you are able to do the same process and, you know, convert it into the SCCM world and then deploy it within your task sequence. So first thing that we need to do is locate a Windows 11 machine. Now, this is the Windows 11 machine that I am going to do the customization first. I'm going to right click on the start menu. I'm going to select run. I'm going to type in WinVer and I'm going to hit OK. Now, I'm doing everything within a Windows 11 version 23H2. Okay. So on the desktop, I am going to open up the start menu and start removing everything that you don't want. This is what I want for my layout. Just Edge, Settings, Power Explorer, and the calculator. That's it. So once you have your customization the way that you want it, we need to open up the File Explorer. Within the File Explorer, at the top of your File Explorer, click inside the address bar, and we're going to type in the following. Percent local app data, percent, hit enter. It's going to redirect you here. Awesome. We're going to locate and double click on the packages folder and scroll all the way down until you locate Microsoft Windows Start Menu Experience Host. And at the end of it, there's a bunch of gibberish with numbers and letters. Double click on the folder. And from here, we need to get into the local state folder. So locate it, double click on it. And that start2.bin file, that is what is actually your start menu. Okay. So make a copy of it, paste it somewhere. Well, for me, I actually made a copy and pasted it into my MDT server, which we will head over right now. Bingo. And there goes the file. So I just copied it and pasted it within my MDT server. You could do the same thing with your SCCM. Now, for all this to work, we're going to be using a PowerShell script, which I will provide. Don't worry about it. So I open up PowerShell ISE and I'm going to open up the PowerShell script. And this is it. We declared the location of our start2.bin file. We're declaring where we're going to drop it, the default profile. We're doing an if statement, and then we're copying our start2.bin file to the location, which would be the default profile location. So that basically means whoever logs into the machine is going to get that start menu. Awesome. So make sure you save this file where the start2.bin file is located. Now, I actually dropped everything inside the desktop of my MDT server. And because what's going to happen is when you call out the source files, it's going to grab those files and then move it over to your deployment share. So open up your MDT console. We're going to go into the applications folder. Select it, right-click on it, click on New Application. We're going to leave the default, which would be Application with Source Files. Click on Next. Provide a publisher, application name, version, and language. The only thing that you actually need to provide here would be the name. So I gave it the following. Pretty self-explanatory, right? Click Next here. Now the source. Again, I created a folder inside my MDT server on the desktop. I called it this. Inside that folder has the start2.bin file as well as the PowerShell file. So during this new application wizard is going to take those two things and then move it over to your deployment share. Click Next here. Specify the name of the directory. I left it as the default. Click Next. Now this is where the magic happens, the command line. This is the following command that I am going to use. I am going to call out that PowerShell script. Now, you don't have to name it what I gave it. You could change the name, it's up to you, but just make sure you add the correct name here with the .ps1 extension, okay? Click Next. Nice little summary. Click Next. Confirmation. We are done. Click Finish. There goes our new application. So let's head over to the task sequence folder. I'm going to select my Windows 11 task sequence. I'm going to double click on it. I'm going to go into the task sequence tab. And then from here, I'm going to select the custom task folder. I'm going to click on add. I'm going to go into general and I'm going to select, install application. Awesome. Change the name. This is what I gave it. We're going to select install a single application, then click on browse, and then select your new application, which was the Windows 11 start menu. Pretty easy, right? Click OK. Let's click apply. Let's OK it. Awesome. Now we're going to select our deployment share node. We're going to right click on it. We're going to update our deployment share. We're going to click next here. We're going to click next and complete it. Now at the end of the video, you're going to see a nice quick demo of how everything worked with a new deployment. It worked with no problem. It was pretty awesome. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.